Oh yeah.
Just a little bit. Thank you. Put your gas back. Drop the bucket.
Huh?
Drop the bucket.
Drop the bucket.
Tell them to pull the bucket down.
Pull the bucket.
Lever on the left. Push it forward. There you go. All the way.
Okay, now what?
Shut the sucker off.
Turn the switch off.
There you go. Nothing to
it. Is that all he has to do?
Turn the gas off, put the damn tin can back on a exhaust pipe, and you're all set.
Put the tin can back on there so the water doesn't get in the...
Doesn't run down to the intake valve.
Right.
Gas off. I got it off.
That's enough?
Okay.
Did a good job.
You did a good job.
Yeah.
Proud of you.
Stephen. Proud of John you. Deere.
Stephen Alice Chalmers. That's Alice Chalmers.
Stephen and Alice are engaged now.
Yeah.
Is it a Hoyt Clagwell?
Yeah. Green Acres?
So now
yeah.
Now
yeah.
I can go back.
Wish we had one of them.
It was some kind of acres. I don't know if it was green or not. But.
First time he comes back to school.
Sandy Acres.
And yeah. He's going to have show and tell time. He can say he played
show
with his putt-putt in Grandpa's backyard.
Yeah. Putt-putt.
All right, Debbie.
Can you discipline your child?
Or
I gotta get up knocking the living crap out of him. Huh?
What
is it?
We're just having
I'm with 60 Minutes. I'm Harry Reasoner.
No comment. Go get the...
I heard something about that tractor.
He wants to know about the tractor.
I heard that you had several connections. Where you got this from? Iran-Contra. You got this from Iran-Contra affairs. Please cooperate and you know we'll literally let you off easy on this one.
You hit that camcorder and they won't let you off nothing, boy.
I got a bike.
I could, I would.
Turn it off,
Stephen. We got enough tape. Turn it off.
Ah! We can get you a very special interview. Come here, yeah. I'll show you. Right here. Be careful.
Don't you put dog poop on tape.
This is dog do. I hope that it's hard. Because we're just a couple of average guys.
How much does this cost?
Our favorite food. Yeah. Ever drug for different folks?
Yeah. Here. Spare the rod, spoil the child. Yeah.
Steven, that's enough.
What's the matter with this guy? Is he crazy?
I'm a wrestler. Tell her I'm a wrestler.
You're a wrestler, all right.
Another one of my jobs, shit detail.
Poop, poop, ba-doop.
Absolutely. Shit detail.
What did you say, Don?
Oh, it looks like dinner time.
Lick the camera.
I wasn't gonna lick.
Don't lick the camera. No ice cream cones on the camera. There's a big D.
See you in a while.
Okay. Tell him we said hi. Tell him I said hi, Dave.
Yeah, give her.
Me too.
Give great grandpa Schultz my regards.
Hey, Steven, come on. We got a movie show with us.
We're gonna have to use the gain up on it.
If I turn your light on here, so that camera works
a little better.
Hi, little boy. Hi. Hello,
Grandpa. How you doing?
Hey there.
How are
you doing?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
what
a year, boy.
3 years. Yeah,
uh-huh. Can I give you a little hug?
Right there.
Okay.
I got a spot on the back on the kitchen, and I can't.
Yeah. There we go. Now we got the showtime here.
Who's that tall kid?
Oh boy. Where'd you get that? That's a big expensive thing.
Hey there, Grandpa.
He woke me up this morning about 7:30. He said you pulled in last night.
Oh, really?
8 o'clock last night,
right? Yeah. Always thought we'd come by here and visit.
What happened?
I've been working on the work and I just come in 2 minutes.
I thought I wasn't going to be here at noon. He almost took me to hospital this morning. Same thing I had before in my chest, you know?
Uh-huh.
And about 2 years ago. Oh, man, I got on. I was so sick. I still am, but I've been trying to straighten up the house, but I can't. Too far gone I am.
Hey, Stephen, let me go ahead and have the camera there.
My little boy.
Little boy?
You can be big boy, though.
You might give him growing food down there and make him grow tall, huh?
Hey, Graham.
Yeah, hey, yeah.
And not grandma, great-grandma.
Yeah?
Yeah, and they got another little fella. I don't see him, but Dad said he...
I'm going to go see him before you go back. Andy!
Oh. Andy!
Andy's a boy.
He'll say when we go by, he'll say, Andy's out there getting ready. He's a shovel in the snow, or I see he's getting the stuff ready.
First time I seen him, he was out in the car. That hospital bawling his old tail off in the car. Hey, that's a nice little boy there, Andy. He's just a crying. What they done to him just before then.
It's away. Say something, that's here.
No, he's gone right in there. They got to say something to him.
You're supposed to talk, and that's your talk there. You won't do no good in the movie.
What's going on after a grass fire?
Eckert
over here. What's grass fire? What's cool?
What's cool road? I didn't hear nothing. I heard him talking out there.
My sister's birthday, the 27th.
What's burning there? What? You mean where they've done the bulldozer in that place?
Huh. Well, you take all the accidents on the road going up and down?
Yeah. We got some good wrecks.
Hey, what's your little location, Larry?
My sister.
That's where he was.
I would. I had a picture of my baby. She said he's 42 or 43.
Go for a walk back here when you see some deer.
Yeah? Okay.
Quack, quack.
Money or property?
No, I wouldn't tell them at all.
Money. They know I got it in there.
They know anyway, see, because they got
it. They know anyway. They know everything the government does.
They got, see, this thing has his social security number already.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And they report that. Okay, let me explain this to you. Okay, Benny, deal is this. Now, if you take out more money than...
No, let's not go get no more.
Bring your income level over $25,000 a year, then you're going to be liable for taxes on half of your social... $30 taken out of it every month for...
Insurance.
First, and you call that insurance.
Hospital
bills. Uh-huh. They took them didn't find enough to take that money away from you in 20 years to get it back.
Well, this is the only, out of 700, oh, you said, you're saying, uh-huh. Okay, so he can take out 20,000. They can tell you if there's any kind of taxes that you might owe.
Yeah, call.
They'll take care of you and won't charge you anything. Money that you're earning interest on, nothing to do with it.
Movies over here.
So you're safe there.
Mm-hmm. They're taking movies over here.
I know it. You have to pay a percentage of taxes.
You gotta get a bite to eat, I guess.
This house?
This is giving in, the whole kitchen is. I want to put new sort of a piece of paperboard, and 2x2s.
He's driving?
Which one of them? Daddy born and kid born. Daddy bonehead or kid bonehead?
Oh. Something on the
film.
Posterity.
Yeah. Yeah, he's quite a guy, you know. Big man. With a sore shoulder. Oh, you don't get it. All right. I don't know. Heartline.
Uh-huh. Saturday morning isn't good.
They didn't have too many particulars. They didn't even know anything about funeral arrangements or anything.
Try to get a shot of her just outside that light right there so that the...
Was that you operating that camera in my room?
No, it's not.
That was him.
I thought it was Rick, but I couldn't see his features to know who it was.
Oh.
I can't see any of your features.
I've been alive 2 years.
Well, you...
He's
you have those fits often?
He's...
No.
He's talking about my
grandmother Schultz.
My grandmother Schultz.
His grandmother, you know, she's a character. Her and her husband, Harry and Viola, they're Violet. Violet.
Their sister's Viola.
Yeah, right. And what's she, in her 80s now?
She's 78 years old.
How old is it? Oh. Grandpa Harry.
82.
82.
He works in the out there in the junkyard ever?
Ever since he got it, he's been really obnoxious.
Uh-huh. He filmed the storm and everything else with that thing.
Well, you got a lot of trees down, a lot of branches down up here, all along the Parnell.
Yeah.
A lot of them.
Right after the storm, you couldn't get out of the Parnell either way. The road was just...
Yeah, you got a lot down.
Did you have a bunch of trees come down here or something?
Yeah, last Sunday.
Really?
Oh.
I was telling them you didn't have
them. If you look out those two windows, you see the neighbor's trees?
Mm-hmm.
They were bent right over, touching their roof.
Those big maple trees right in front of their house.
I mean, it was blowing like you couldn't believe.
We were just talking about that.
What do you want me to do? Whop your mom in the head or something? A little excitement or something? Is that what you want? Action film?
When we get ready to go home, you go get in that yellow car out there in the corner.
Oh, that's all
door.
That open up, you mean the convertible out there?
The convertible and drive it to the north.
You want him to drive over that little grass?
No, but we're going. No, but we're going home in two cars.
Maybe.
Oh, I don't know. You don't have too much trouble.
Well, two times.
There you go.
That's a patient of explanation.
Not if you ever want to drink booze, I don't think you better.
Ooh,
old dog so right there.
Uh-huh.
He was, I guess, classified as a foreman in the tool crib. Yeah, there's only two guys in the tool crib. That's Joe Picori, remember?
It's an old, at the, they go like this. Like this with their hands.
About 3 weeks
and then the second thing they do. And they go like a do-si-do. Everybody in a big circle, everybody that's there.
Come here, I'll
hear them all doing that at the same time. Pride's family, which is like a tribe, they have social and religious feelings that are different from the groom's. You've bought two families together as one, which that's what wedding is supposed to be in that way.
Please.
When you do that,
oh, are you suffering?
The whole world is yours.
No, no.
Please.
Thank you. It's amazing. The most remarkable thing is, before I came there and started having those shots in that area,
well, it sucks.
The average wedding reception was 20 minutes.
We can arrange that, too.
Oh, yeah.
The way a Southern wedding works.
Oh, yeah.
How long did he stay in?
Yes.
Huh? How long did he stay in?
Overnight. Then they threw him out. They couldn't take it anymore.
And the surrounding distributors.
Old man Peters came up with the money and bailed them all out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Knock it off. Yeah.
No. Got to get everybody's pretty mug on here.
Bill and...
Operation is not...
Mug.
Here we are.
Well, he's keeping his overhead down.
Well,
and Grace's brother, they brought home because he was a juvenile.
He just felt like, I'll do it myself. And
it was Don and
his kid.
Bill Peters, Marv Hugemeyer.
And they all rolled up.
Of course.
It's going on to
Vic Keynes, Grace's brother,
so he doesn't have any money to turn this thing over to when he gets older.
Victor. Victor was, but,
so basically
Victor
all
was
the thing's going to be.
Tissue.
I have a tissue, Mom. You know what? When probably
the last kitchen.
Yeah, he has to see the green light.
I got it. This one. Smile, say hello. Hi there. Are we a nervous mom? Yeah, look at that nervousness. Uh-oh, here comes Papa Bear. He's after me again.
Where's the that tape there?
Somebody had it. I'm not sure where it went to.
Where that tape went to?
Rachel, do you know where the duct tape is?
Approach making the world a better place by making their own personal world better. in our world would be near as a paradise. So as you leave the gymnasium for junior high for the last time after class, think about the future. Let your fear and your excitement work to make our world a better place. Use your fear and uncertainty that our world is becoming filled with violence, hatred, intolerance, and greed to drive you to clean it up. Use your excitement for a world filled with beauty and love to help put these graces back in our world on a grander scale. Let these two visions of the future be your influence in succeeding in making the world a better place.
administration has signed to select you the top 11 students academically in the class of 93. And this is truly an outstanding class. I will present them as they are ranked with one exception. We have two valedictorians. Both students took the real tough courses, and both students have straight A's. I will introduce them alphabetically. Valedictorian, Linda Chang.
Dr. Spence has been a teacher, administrator of South Carolina Public
He has twice presented papers to the International Convention of the American Personnel and Guidance Association, has been a leader at Family Life Conference, and has directed workshops and seminars for college and high school teachers. With so much experience in working with and guiding young people through life and career choices, Dr. Spence's words on this commencement evening will, I'm sure, be meaningful and memorable. I present to you Dr. Spence.
But as I sat there,
that were professors, that were doctors, that were lawyers, that were farmers, that were housewives. A little lady about that tall, gray-haired city, ran up to me and called my name, and I looked on her nameplate, and it was the actress. It was my girlfriend when I was a sophomore in high school. I really didn't know what had happened to her. After a while, she called her husband over and said, I want you to meet. He said, are you really the man? I said, yes, I am. He said, did you know I beat your kind? I began to investigate. Since I had grown up with that girl, or that man who beat my kind, she had had 12 children and has 29 grandchildren. So, you know, you can just surmise what you want to about that statement. But I will tell you about the world you live in today. I know that you read on the front page of the paper all the bad stuff that's happening, all the killings that are taking place, all the bad things that are going on around the world. But did you know that 90% of all the scientists that have ever lived since the beginning of mankind are living right now in your generation? 90%. I taught a class at King College one time and had a very interesting statistic in front of the book. From year one to year 1750, knowledge doubles. From 1750 to 1900, knowledge doubled a second time. From 1900 to 1950, knowledge doubled a third time, and since 1950, knowledge has been doubling every 10 years. Which means when you enter school, well, 13 years ago, knowledge has almost doubled twice since you entered school. So you can see what the future holds for you. I know that you have been looking forward to this day. But I want you to know that this is a commencement. It is not an ending, it is a beginning. When you get your diploma and you walk out and you feel like, hey, this is what I've always been waiting for. It is just the beginning of learning. The real problem in the world today is not all the inventions that are taking place, because there are so many taking place that we can hardly keep up with them. But it is our interaction with ourselves and with one another. Are you truly happy tonight? The psychologist Jung said that the central neurosis of our time is endless. Lowell May has said that we are living in an age of unrelatedness. Arthur Miller has written in After the Fall, when the standard for infantry clean this case, we are having a hard time in 1993 really listening to one another, really reaching out, really making all of us a family. Ernest Hemingway wrote in Death in the Afternoon, my life is as empty as a radio tube without any current plugged into it. That means that he was a complete vacuum. I trust that that is not the type of world that you are going to help to build. You want to build a world of interrelatedness. You want to build a world of love and trust. You want to build a world of respect. And we depend on you. Our generation has made a mess out of some things we intended to do, but we have also left a great area for you to build on. There are two or three thoughts I will leave with you. First, you've got to use what you have. And all of you have an attitude. All of you have a talent. All of you are men and women of worth and dignity. An ant cannot build a cathedral, but an ant can build an anthill. And if it's torn down and you kick it over, all of them will work together and come back and rebuild. There's a little poem that I learned a long time ago that has been so meaningful to me. Do what you can, be what you are. Shine like a glowworm if you can't like a star. Work like a pulley if you can't like a train. Be a wheel greaser if you can't ride the train. Everybody is important. Now, you don't remember 1970, but I do. I was sitting in front of the TV one afternoon, and I was watching a ball game between
16, and you are the 10th of all, 14 seconds, 63 yards from the goal. And so they decided they would do what had never been done in professional football. They were going to attempt a field goal of 63 yards. And so they called out their field goal kicker. And as this man came hopping out on the field, he had a club foot. He had an arm. He hobbled as he came out. He did not look like a football player. But that man backed off. His name was Tom Dempsey. And he ran at that ball, and with his club foot, with his deformed foot, he hit that ball and went 63 yards. Went through the uprights, and New Orleans won the game in the last second. But he used what he had, and he used the great man, and that's what we all need to do. Several years ago, I had the opportunity to go to Israel, and while there, we went down by the seashore, a beautiful sea. People were fishing on the sea. Children were running and playing along the shore. There were trees growing up. A few days later, we went down to another body of water. We didn't see anybody fishing. We didn't see any trees along the seashore. There were no flowers blooming. People did not really seem to be too happy. And I began to think, you know, both of those seas had fed into it the water from the same stream, the Jordan River. What happened as the Jordan River flowed into the Sea of Galilee? Every rock that the Sea of Galilee received, it gave out. It came in, it gave it out. It shared what it had. That same river flowed on down to the Dead Sea. But the Dead Sea did something different. The Dead Sea hoarded what it had. It did not share. It did not give up one drop of the Jordan River that flowed into it. It stayed there. That is exactly a pattern of life. If you take what you have learned during these years and build on it, and let it flow from you to touch other people around you, a better world will be left when you go to your 50th high school reunion. And then you've got to keep setting that new goal. We talked about Babe Ruth hitting 714 home runs, but did you know that Babe Ruth struck out 1,339 while he was hitting those 714 home runs? You're not always going to win, but you're going to always keep trying. You know, we can give up so easily. The football player was down on the field. The coach ran out. The trainer ran out. They began to talk with him. Finally, the guy fell back up on his feet. And they looked at him. They said, "How do you feel, son?" He said, "Well, I can't see too well." The coach looked over at him and said, "But you have your helmet turned crooked. You're looking out the gear hole, turning around, son. And you'll be able to see okay." You know, a lot of us are like that in life. We are looking through the wrong thing, through the wrong glasses. Then, last of all, you've got to learn to live yourself. If you don't like who you are, chances are you're not the one in life who's sitting around you and really gonna walk down the road of life with. In the good book, it says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. It means if you don't appreciate who you are, what you have, and what you have to contribute, then chances are you're not gonna have any respect for anyone else. You've got to learn how to life is ridiculous. Not wearing your feelings on your sleeve. There's a little story about a doctor, a psychiatrist, going through a psychiatric ward. He was busy with the patients, and he came to one patient, and he said, "Hello there." And the patient said, "Well, hello, doctor." And the doctor looked at him and said, "What is your name, sir?" He said, "My name is Napoleon." "Oh, Napoleon. Who told you your name was Napoleon?" He said, "God did." And the man in the next bed said, "I did not." There will be someone you're trying to stop, to put shackles on them. But don't stop. We need you in this world, in this universe. I'm looking at a few doctors and lawyers and housewives
what life was really all about. His name was David. And he said, trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and there is thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. May God bless you.
John Patrick Carter. Stacy Lee Klein. David E. Coker. J.L. Collins. Denise Renee Collins. Charles Raymond Thomerton Jr. John Gale Thompson. Catherine Ann Thomas. Stacy Marcel Cook. Aaron Scott Crawford. Nikki A. Crawford. Richard J. McCombo. Christian Lee Cunningham. Stephanie Dawn Cunningham. James Ben Crusader. Patrick A. Shabor. Jane Matthew Dowell. David Allen Duff. Melissa D. Eaton. Tiffany Margaret Emmer. Jennifer Ann Neiman. Ellen Colleen Evans. William L. Everson. Laura Elizabeth Fetter.
Laura!
Matthew Jason Fields. Stephanie Renee Lynn. Jessica Ashley Jones. Rachel Lynn King. Missy Renee Kisner. Charles Troy Lehman.
Even Lee.
Cynthia Lois Simpson. David Edward Smallwood. Jennifer Renee Smith. Stephen Patrick Snodgrass. Yasmin Ali Solomon. Nicole Lee Stewart. Sandy Marshall Stewart. Stacy Fred Sapp. Angela Michelle Sauer. Tina B. Swan. Lori Chance Ray Tatum. Norman Teaster. A. Scott Thomas. Jennifer Lynn Thomas. Joseph Michael Thomas. Bethany Moretz Thompson. Christopher Aaron Thompson. Billie Jean Trinkle. Richard Kirk. Scott P. Burley.
Christopher Brandon Wright. Action News reporter. There's just been a breakout of the L block of Virginia High School. The entire senior wing has escaped the building. We'll have details at 11. There's the proud mama right here.
Say something.
Congratulations, Stephen.
Yeah.
Or don't you guys want to say something like, get a job and move out now?
Yeah,
yeah, you're on your own, kid.
We get our den back.
You're out of the house by tomorrow noon.